Hello everyone, myself Ankit Shivare, and today we are going to discuss on parallel resonant circuits. So this is lecture 2 in the resonant circuit series circuits. So this is lecture 2. Okay, so in the last lecture we have discussed on series resonant circuits, where actually RLC are in series connections and we are modeled it by connecting a voltage source with it, right? Now in parallel resonant circuits we will model it by connecting a current source, okay, current source with RLC in parallel, right? So it's better to go with the admittance notations for these circuits, right? Because parallel always, like, it will be addition, right? Simply additions you have to do, that's it. So right, this is the addition that you have to do, plus plus, right? So this is nothing but 1 by R plus 1 by j omega L plus j omega C, right? In the phasor term we can just j component, imaginary component, divided by the real component, okay? So this is nothing but 10 inverse of omega c minus 1 by omega l divided by 1 by r, right? Now the thing that is interesting to us is, like, DC frequency. What will happen in DC frequency case when omega tends to 0? So in this case, this capacitor will act like what? It will act like an open circuit, right? For omega tends to 0. And so this circuit will look like this way, right? So it will have a I, it will, this L is there, right? Then there is some C, and then there is an R, right? Now how will your inductor behave in this case when omega is tending to 0? Omega is tending to 0, it implies what? This DC switch, right? It will act like a switch which is short, right? So you have closed the switch, so this is a short circuit, okay? But how will capacitor will behave? That is 1 by omega C. Omega is tending to 0, right? So this is an infinity. So in a way your switch is open, so you have opened your switch, right? And this is your R. So what you are seeing is you have a short circuit path, right? So the whole current will flow from the inductor, right? So the current will flow like this, right? So what is the admittance that you are seeing is infinity, but your impedance is what? Infinity is, impedance is zero. So in this case your Z of j omega is nothing but zero, ideally, right? If impedance doesn't have any resistor, then whole current is flowing through the impedance from the inductance, right? Your phase is what? Minus pi by 2, okay? This is your phase, okay? So you can substitute here omega is equal to 0, so you will get minus infinity, and that is nothing but minus pi by 2. That is the phasor of admittance, right? So this is nothing but called as admittance. Yeah, I've already shown, okay? So omega tends to infinity, what will happen? So now your omega is tending to infinity, so this is the circuit now, right? So in this condition your L will act like an open circuit and your capacitance will act like a short circuit, right? Because this is omega L, right? So omega is tending to infinity, so this is a very high value, and this is what? 1 by omega C. This is omega L and this is 1 by omega C. So omega C will tend to 0 when omega is tending to infinity. Omega L is tending to infinity when omega is tending to infinity, okay? So this is the thing that we are judging, right? So this is the notation we have. So what we are seeing is, again, there is a short circuit path, but this short circuit path is nothing from the capacitor. So whole current will flow from the capacitor, okay? The capacitor will keep on building the voltage, right, from the current source. Now you can see the plot. So this is y omega, j omega. So we can see here that omega is tending to infinity, the magnitude is going to infinity. When omega is tending to 0, the magnitude is again going to infinity. Same, you can see in j of j omega. So like this will be like this way, right? So it is tending to 0. Here it is tending to 0. At resonant, the impedance is what? That is nothing but simply R. Okay. So that is the minimum, maximum impedance that you get at resonant frequency, okay? Now the thing is, what is y of j omega, right? Now about the phase. So phase will be like this, right? So phase will be 0 at resonant frequency, omega naught. Now we have not solved for resonant frequency, let us solve for it, okay? So let us solve for at omega is equal to omega naught, right? at omega is equal to omega naught. So what was your y j omega? Y of j omega we are calculating at omega is equal to omega naught, right? It was nothing but 1 by r what plus j omega c minus j divided by omega l, right? So this is nothing but 1 by r plus j and omega naught c minus 1 by omega naught l. Okay, omega is equal to omega naught is substituted, right? So at omega is equal to omega naught, what we are stating that admittance, your imaginary term is zero, or in a way admittances cancel each other. So what will be the condition like? Omega naught c is equal to 1 by omega naught l. So in this way you get omega naught is nothing but 1 by under root of lc. So now when we substitute here, what we get? Y of j omega, and what is the phase now? Y of j omega is nothing but tan inverse of omega c minus 1 by omega l whole divided by 1 by r, right? And omega c and omega l are cancelling each other, right? So this is nothing but 0. Your magnitude of y of j omega is nothing but simply 1 by r, right? So your voltage and current are in phase here. At this point your v comma I are in phase, okay? So this is the calculations that we'll have at resonant frequency, okay? The magnitude and the phase. So the plots that we have plotted was like this, right? We were plotting y of j omega with respect to omega, and then the plot that we were seeing was the admittance was going infinity, right? The admittance was going infinity. Y of j omega was going infinity, right? So this was like this. Okay. So this is the 1 by r. Okay, and this is at omega is equal to omega naught. Okay. When you stretch this same curve for angle of y of j omega, this we say at 0. So here what will happen? The phase will be same, right? Constant. So the circuit, what we saw, it was like minus 90 degree. We see this omega axis and this is plus 90 degree in the y axis. Okay. So what we are seeing there, was a phase like this format, right? Right? And now what about z of j omega? How was z of j omega will look, was looking like? Your z of j omega in the same conditions, right? So it was like this form, right? It was going 0, then it is going to minimum, right? So this is your omega is equal to omega naught. So that is the maximum impedance that you get, that is nothing but r, right? What about the phase? Angle z of z omega, nothing but you are getting like this, right? Plus 90 degree, and it was changing like this, right? It was going from 90 degree to minus 90 degree, and this is the change that you are getting, omega is equal to omega naught. Okay, I hope it is very clear to you. Already we have derived it for series resonant circuits, and same derivation we have done for parallel resonant circuits. In the next lecture, we will discuss on quality factor and also bandwidth relationships, right? So that is very important lecture, okay?
If you like this video and you want us to create more such videos, please don't hesitate to like, share and subscribe to TechDude.